Hey guys, welcome to episode one of a brand new series. I'm coming at you from the newly live CreatureKay SMP. A good friend of mine started this server up and it's been up for literally just a couple of minutes. So we're going to dive into this and see what kind of shenanigans we can get into. We're going to build some stuff. We're gonna hang out with some people. We're going to play some games, do some shops, some farms, whatever the server takes us to. I'm really, really excited. I can't wait to show you guys. So I'm going to run tape and see what trouble we can get into. I'll bring you guys back in when we're doing something for real. So it's going to take me a little bit of getting used to do recordings on an SMP. My computer totally did not like recording and streaming at the same time on a brand new server. So we're back in to give you guys a rundown of what we actually accomplished today. We're all kind of hanging out in this village. We got about, I think, like 6, 7, 8 people. I don't know. We got a whole bunch of people on this server. And we did a little group project. When they asked what I wanted to get done day one, I was like, I want to get an iron farm up. Day one iron farm sounds like an accomplishment to me. So I put most of my effort in over here. This is a raised works design. Oop, we're in a hole. A lot of creeper holes in this world. We got to get this place better lit up. And once we finished getting that together, which getting the zombie in the cauldron was a nightmare. But this place is actually producing a pretty good amount of iron for us already, which is going to take a lot of stress off of mining other than getting some diamonds so we can get to the next level. I'm just super stoked to be playing with other people. Like, whether we got this done or not, I was just happy to be on for the day. And after we did the iron farm, went on a little nether adventure. Myself and Darker Midnight went and found a fortress, and unfortunately, that's where I logged my first death on the server. Survived, 3.5, almost 4 hours with no deaths, kicking butt, getting things done, and I stupidly mined a block that was holding back lava. A block that I had placed, nonetheless. So, I came back, got ready to go on an epic mining trip, and decided it was a good time to call it for the day. We have an iron farm. We have a portal to the nether. We have the start of a nice building over here that our buddies have put together. And it's just been great. Before I logged off, I did a little sorting of the chest to make it a little bit more organized for everyone. And yeah, this is all just super fun. This is my first official SMP that I'm doing a series on and that I expect to be for a long time. So hopefully it goes well and hopefully you guys enjoy the content. I'll get some more playing and grinding done and we'll talk again in a moment for you, but it's probably going to be a little bit for me. All right, see you in a second, guys. It has indeed been quite some time since that last clip. We randomly hit affiliate, which I did not expect to hit, on Twitch for at least a couple of weeks, and I decided that a 24-hour celebration stream was in order. Yeah, 24 hours. It was amazing and exhausting at the same time, but as you can see, we're nicely geared up after that session. The dome has been finished around the iron farm. We had to make a few repairs for everybody, where our nether portal is looking nice. And a few other things have happened. Before we dive into a grand tour of everything that's been updated in the last 48 hours, 24 of which I was sleeping for, and the other 24 of which I was streaming for, let's show you guys the highlights from the caving reel, because some fun stuff happened over there. Nice. Okay, 5 is good. Ooh, 6 is even better. I mean, quick caving for me tends to end in deaths, but ooh, diamonds. Well, now you all have to die, because those are now my diamonds. Spider spawner. Ooh, music disc. Wait a second. I'm making a music box. Yeah, jamming out. Oh shit, I'm in lava. sky. I mean, dark. I disconnected. I'm in lava. Can you come back and clear the lava? Okay, I just saw you place the water. Logging in.
You're safe.
On one heart. Despite nearly logging a second lava death on the server, we were able to create a pretty efficient spider grinder, and we wouldn't have been able to do so without the help of our good friends. So this is why you play on an SMP, everybody, so that when you do stupid things, your buddies can come and rescue you, and everything works out for the better. Darker Midnight and CJ totally pulled me out of the fire, literally. And then we worked together to finish the spider grinder, which, I gotta say, turned out pretty good, and I just so happened to roll Bane of Arthropods when I went to enchant my sword. Normally a very unexciting thing, but it does make this go quite faster, and I'm able to get a little bit of XP, a little bit, and we got tons of string, which we can trade with our villagers. That's right, we have villagers. Because 24 hours is a lot of time. So, we made a lot of projects happen, one of which is the start of a nice little villager, I'm not going to say trading hall. It's more of an internment camp connected to my house. But for the moment, it's going to have to do. It did manage to get us mending and silk touch. So I'm pretty happy. Let's go over and check it out, as well as what we've done to the house over there, because I did wind up claiming a house in the town, and I want to show you guys what I did. So this is our house. This is officially where we live. That's right. I actually did a normal Minecraft house for once. I'm not living underground, we're not doing some crazy sky build or weird treehouse or something. I have a legitimate home. Nicely modeled with some flowers outside, and I mean, this is not the prettiest thing ever, but it's very functional. We have a whole little villager camp just off the backside of our house. Now, it may look small from the outside, but what I did is I got efficient with vertical space. We have a lofted bed. We have some storage up here, which we haven't made use of quite yet. But what really makes this house shine is our wine cellar, which isn't quite complete yet. We need to get some more barrels in here and some more chests, do a little lighting and some decoration. But isn't it so nice? I mean, this is what Minecraft dreams are made of, right, guys? As we all know, dreams and nightmares are opposite sides of the same proverbial coin. And we have had some nightmares in the form of, oh my god, here it is. These are the nightmares, live and in action, ladies and gentlemen. That is exactly what I was talking about right there. These little guys have just been annihilating the place. And we've gotten lucky, we've gotten good, and we're going to show you a little bit of the landscaping we've done before we get blown up. Over here, we had a ton of creeper holes from those nightmarish green, whatever they are. And I decided before getting off this world that I wanted to tidy it up, make it look nice for all of us. So we shaped the land a little bit in some spots. There are still a few holes and some fresh explosions since I did the landscaping because it is an active server. But all in all, this place is a little bit more together. And we're going to start adding more paths and more buildings. I'm sure the guys have plenty of plans of their own. We do have quite a few people on the server, and even the Nether portal itself has gone through several iterations already in its design. We started with a reclaimed portal from one that spawned naturally, and it's gone through a few phases. I did the little stairway path leading up to it, and since I've logged, someone else has gone ahead and added some more decoration. So this is one of the advantages to an SMP, ladies and gentlemen, is in addition to them saving your butts when you do dumb things, you also come on to see things that you wouldn't have seen otherwise and wouldn't have thought to do yourself. I look forward to seeing everything that everybody does on this server. I didn't even have any hand in building this building, and I think it's absolutely wonderful. We've got a little service entrance off to the side. This way leads down to our loot, and our iron farm is producing well for us. One of the other things I decided to do for the server was make sure that the town had an enchanting setup. This building is going to be next on our conversion list, since having these books on the outside, I'm not quite thrilled with. If somebody else does it before I get on, so be it. But if not, this is probably going to be our next project, and I will do my very best to time-lapse it for you guys. We haven't done any time-lapses yet. You guys know I love time-lapses, and we are going to get some in for sure. The other things we've done on the server are very small. You know, just we've been doing sheep, we've been grinding carrots. I'd say the most eventful thing, what am I doing with rotten flesh? Get out of here. The most eventful thing, although very grindy in and of itself, is the villagers. We took a look in from outside, but this is our little villager pen. The guys decided to go with red, white, and blue here. I don't know if that was intentionally patriotic or just the colors we had. I'm guessing just the colors we had. And we've got quite a few villagers over here. We've been taking our time adding trades so that we can make best use of them, and because we have to get some farms going and to get more resources. Our farmers are leveling up nicely so we can get some golden carrots in our life. And we have a librarian over here who started out with Silk Touch for 5 and then opened up Respiration 2, not so great, but this right here, Mending for 14. Not the best price I've ever seen on Mending, but definitely not the worst. And so those are two very important things. We haven't gotten that on our pick yet because we rolled Fortune 3, which, I'll be honest, I'm not very upset about at this point. We need all the stuff we can get. And if I'm going to Fortune 3 it, so be it. But in addition to Fortune 3 on our pickaxe, we've gone ahead and rolled our sword, which I showed you before. In addition to Bane of Arthropods, we got Knockback, Mending, and Unbreaking. Axe wound up with Efficiency 3, Mending, and Silk Touch, which is pretty okay, I would say, at this stage in the game. And we've got a badass shovel if you want flint all the time. I'm not a big fan of Fortune shovels, personally. I generally go with Silk Touch or nothing. But we take what we get. We make things happen. It was able to help us do our landscaping, not out there, out that way, because now we can insta-mine dirt at least. And I think that does it for the tour. Let's see what else is going on real quick. I think somebody put something up over here. Let's go see what this action is about. This is very exciting. I actually get to check out somebody else. I keep winding up with this rotten flesh. Stay out of my inventory. I have a flint and steel. Die! Again. Okay. Bee farm. I'm not going to open that door. I want to open that door. I know nobody's doing like other videos at the moment, so I'm not afraid of spoilers. I am, however, afraid of letting all of the bees out because I have no idea what's behind that door. And if I let all the bees out, I got to get them back in. And I'm going to bed very soon. I'm going to bed. That is Darker Midnight's tower. We just jumped in to look, so I figured I'd tell you. He's doing a phenomenal job. This is his entrance, a little creeper-faced mountainside with a waterfall, and he's making use of some of the nether blocks to do up his doorway. I believe he's got big, big plans, and this tower is a really great landmark for finding the village here. I don't know what we're doing next. I truly don't, because I said I'm going to bed. So give me a second to get a few winks. It's taken quite a bit to recover from that 24-hour stream. And I'll be right back with an idea. I did not go to sleep. I got this idea stuck in my head and had to just do it. You know how it goes when you lay down in bed and your brain won't stop. And I just jumped on, went to work, and this is what we came up with. We got a few little pieces missing here. There's probably a creeper explosion while I was offline. TFC, who is on right now, did a little change to our interior, which is fantastic. He added a little bit of a water feature here using some of the diorite and polished diorite stairs and moved the barrel down here, which I think is a really, really great little thing. I was looking for a way to hide it in here. And frankly, at the end of the night, I was a little burnt out because I stayed up way late doing this build. And although I really liked the way the roof came out, I kind of just threw everything around in here. Anvil and grindstone and lantern were kind of just strewn about. So it was really great to have some other people on the server who care about builds and want to get involved in community stuff. I'm really excited for what we get to do together in the future. This is such a great group of guys, and we're going to have some fun and do some creative stuff. I don't think we have time for any large projects, but I did want to, you know, kind of walk around the area a little bit with shaders on, show you guys what the house looks like with BSL and what the library looks like. Maybe what some slicing of some zombies looks like. That's shader zombie killing. You know, fantastic action. I see the guys have thrown up some more torches around here, which is fantastic. We've got our dome looking good, our nether portal lit up. And I'd like to do a bunch more, but we are getting close to out of time here, guys. So if you've made it this far, I appreciate you. And if you could hit that like and subscribe, it helps us. I hate making those requests, but the numbers say I have to. Look at TF over there, making our community storage look awesome. I'm so grateful to know this group. If you guys don't know the group, I'm going to be linking all the channels to the people who stream on the server and do YouTube content on the server. And go ahead and check them out. They all have some interesting stuff going on, cool build ideas, and just all around a great group of people. So I look forward to doing builds and having adventures and doing projects with the guys. I'm probably going to get right on going and recording the next episode pretty soon here, and I hope you guys come back for it. It's been a blast, and I'll see you next time. Have a good one.